Oh, how vulnerable the fallen human heart is. John Piper's heart. Oh, how vulnerable is my heart to feeling that having lots of things means being really alive. How vulnerable I am to equate having and being. Having and living. Just feel it. You go to Best Buy and you feel it. If I had that, I'd be alive. Crazy. Like things. Things are going to give life. That's the lie. Life. What is life? Jesus. This is eternal life, that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom you have sent. Life is not having things. Life is knowing God. So he tells a parable. He told the parable to them. So now I'm telling it to them. These are the people that overheard the question, overheard the little interchange, and now he's looking around in the church and saying, everybody hear this little story about the inheritance? I got a word for all of you. So this is verse 16. He told them a parable. So you listen, Jesus is talking to you. The land of a rich man produced plentifully, and he thought to himself, what shall I do? For I have nowhere to store my crops. And he said, I'll do this. I'll tear down my barns and build bigger ones, and there I will store all my grain and my goods. And I will say to my soul, soul, you have ample goods laid up for years. Relax. Eat. Drink. Be merry. But God said to him, fool, this night your soul will be required of you. And the things you have prepared, whose will they be? So is the one who lays up treasure for himself and is not rich toward God. It is not a bad thing to be a productive farmer. It's not a bad thing when your land produces plentifully. It's not a bad thing when your business prospers. It's not a bad thing when you get a promotion with a pay raise. It's not a bad thing when your investments increase in value. That's not the evil in this parable. He's not called a fool because he was a productive farmer. God knows this world needs productive farmers and profitable businesses. Why is he called a fool? That's the question of the parable. And he's not only a fool, he loses his soul. Verse 20, God said to him, fool, this night your soul will be required of you. He's a damned fool. Strictly. Here's the way I would put it. By the way he used the increase of his riches, he gave no indication of being rich toward God. By the way he used his God-given riches, he gave no indication of being rich toward God. He kept building bigger barns, and that might be okay if you're going to store up grain to use for something that makes God look like your treasure. Bigger barns aren't here or there. It's what he said. It's what he said. Verse 19. I will say to my soul, soul, you have ample goods laid up for you for many years. What are you going to do now? And he blew it. Relax, eat, drink, fun. The use he plans to make of his wealth says one thing. My treasure is relaxing, eating, drinking, and partying. That's my treasure. Those are my riches. That's my life. And the riches in my barns, they make it possible. They're not good, bad, they're just there, making possible that I can get what I will really, really value. Relaxation, food, fun, partying with other retirees. Is that cool? What's wrong with that? Nothing if there's no God and no resurrection. That's what Paul said, right? If the dead are not raised, let's eat and drink. For tomorrow we die. That just makes total sense. Maximize present pleasure if there's no God and no resurrection. No infinitely valuable God to enjoy forever. And then he gives this key, Jesus gives this key concluding verse. Makes the point most clear. Verse 21. So is the one... Going to draw the lesson out now, generalize it for all of us. So is the one who lays up treasure for himself and is not rich toward God. What does that strange phrase mean? Rich toward God. Only place in the Bible it occurs. It's an odd phrase. Rich toward God. That's a good literal translation. What does it mean? I think the meaning is pretty plain from the contrast in the verse. It's opposite. It's the opposite of laying up earthly treasures for yourself. So being rich towards God is the opposite of treating yourself as though it were made for things and not for God. Being rich towards God is the opposite of acting as if life consists in the abundance of your possessions. It doesn't. It consists in knowing God. That's what life is. So being rich toward God is the heart moving toward God as riches. That's simple. Being rich toward God is the heart moving toward God as your riches. Being rich towards God is moving toward God as your treasure. Being rich towards God is counting God greater riches than anything on the earth. Being rich towards God means using earthly riches to show how much you value God. This is what the prosperous farmer failed to do. It's a big farmer fail written over this right here. And the result was that he was a fool and he lost his soul. And we will too if we are not rich toward God. So that's what I meant when I said money is hazardous. It lures you out of love for God. It lures you away from treasuring God. Now again, clarify, the issue here is not that the man's field prospered. The issue is that God ceased to be his treasure. If God has been his treasure, what would he have done differently? If God had been his treasure and not eating and drinking and relaxing and partying, if God had been his treasure, what would he have done differently? Instead of saying, soul, you have ample goods laid up for many years. Relax, eat, drink, be merry. I think instead he would have said something like this. God, this is all yours. You made my fields prosper and you made me. Show me how I can express with my riches that you are my treasure. How can I make that plain in the world, God? I'm a rich man. My fields just, they blew me away. And there it is, available at my disposal. And you pray, oh God, I don't need a bigger and bigger safety net. I don't need a bigger pad. I don't need a bigger and better anything. I don't need better food. I don't need better drink. I don't need better parties. I do want to make merry because you said it is more blessed to give than to receive. So I want to maximize that. So would you just help me know how to invest and how to give this prosperity so that I can make merry and how much good it does others in pointing them to you. Help me discern that.